What is happening, guys? Cowboy here, and we are ready to continue on. So before we go up there, we're actually going to run back across the bridge over here. Get nice and waxed up. Remember, there are two thralls right here, kind of just waiting. So we're going to wait for them to drop down. There they are. As soon as we are waxed, they're going to both go down. Nope. Bad thrall. Stop dodging. Okay, you know what? Screw the thralls. We got our wax. Let's just go. So you're definitely going to want to wax up before this next area. Quite a few instances of BS for us to deal with. Are these thralls coming? They're not. Okay, excellent. So, now for the upper half of the archives. We're going to head on up here. God, that plus 10 damage is absurd. Feel them. As you can see, tons and tons of hands here. We're going to grab the soul. Stop it. This thing has no purpose except for giving you a nice view. Over here should be a chest with some scales in it for us. Yep, got those. We'll take out this guy. Wonder how much more strength I would need to one-shot them. And then we're gonna go this way, get the lizard. And then get the flesh bite ring. Alright, and from here the rooftop shenanigans begin. Roll right here. No point worrying about that. Now there's quite a few gargoyles we're going to be taking on in this area. First one is going to show up right when we go over here to grab this chunk. Listen, that was not necessary. Stop it. Bad gargoyle. Listen here, dude. You're not gonna win this. Just stop. Just die. Let me get my chunk. Everyone will be nice and happy. Alright, now there's gonna be a... this area can be taken two ways. We're gonna actually... This is even easier than the platform roll. So we'll drop down there. Here we have a hollow gem? Yes. Then around the corner for another chunk. Chunks aplenty. Now up ahead we're going to be taking on a storyteller along with some of those super fun monkey bird things. They are a lot scarier. I mean, they're always kind of a scary enemy. But they can be really brutal here. So just keep that in mind. The last thing you want to do is get caught by them. I'd suggest trying to kite them back a little ways. Bring them back here. And then kind of wait for them by the door. And catch them as they're coming on in. I mean, then again, nothing is really scary when you have thugs, because you're basically like a boss. So we have this area right here. Nothing really, just, you know, more aesthetic views. I'm gonna finish you off. Come here. Oh, no. Storyteller, stop it. The mist is not appreciated. Alright, now you don't actually have to kill them, but might as well. So let's see. Hollow gem around the corner for a trunk. Okay. Now we're going to run back this way, and we're going to do a bit of a leap. Let's see, right down there. I don't think you can actually. Can you? Yeah, no, you can't fit through that gap. So get ready and leap. Beautiful. More scales. And then once again, get ready to leap. Leap. Right. So from here, we'll take the ladder back up. This was back where we were fighting the sage earlier, so I would just suggest running past this stuff. You know, it's not a major concern. We'll kill this one thrall. Actually, why not? We're here. We'll just plunging attack, take everything down because fucks can do that. Now, you don't have to worry about wax anymore at this point. If you like having wax on your head, by all means, wax on, but it's no longer needed. We're not going to be running into any more of those ghost hands, so... We'll head back up onto the roof, and this time we're just going to stay on the roof instead of taking the drop-down path. The only real reason to go down there is to get the hollow gem as well as the chunk. There's an item up there. Rest assured, we'll be making our way up there in a bit. Okay, let's see. Alright, so we have a weary warrior soul coming up. If you want, you can do a plunging attack here to hit the storyteller. In previous attempts when I've done that, things usually get a little bit crazy because you're like hitting the storyteller and then everything gets pissed and you're trying to take them all on while dealing with the fall damage you just took. So I like the little drop down that we did. I think it's a little bit safer of a method. God, I still can't believe this thing can one-shot gargoyles. So Crestfallen. Now you can just jump down there, but we're going to actually reach this balcony in a little bit. Now, there's going to be a gargoyle that's going to ambush us here. I would still try and get both crystal lizards if you can. Oh god, Fugs, I love you so much. Oh no! Gargoyle actually took me down. I'm getting a little bit too overzealous because I have Fugs. I mean, like, but at the same time, I think we can all agree the damage potential of this weapon is absolutely astounding. So much so that it's almost like, is this... Like, how is this not nerfed? I mean, I feel like this has to get nerfed. With a patch. Like, it's just, it's too powerful. It's like God mode. But at the same time, it's kind of a double-edged sword. Because of how strong it is, you get lazy. And you're just like, oh, I can just smack this thing to death. I don't need to dodge. Which is, you know, basically what happened there. I didn't even consider dodging. I was just like, no, you know what? I'll just beat this thing down. I don't need to dodge. You're not worth it. Which, obviously, we saw how that worked out. So dodging is still something worth doing. Either way, we'll head back on up. Because we can one-shot gargoyles, we'll just take out that first one. Now, the first one that we encounter, he actually... he won't spawn unless you run towards that chunk. Well, I mean, he'll spawn, but he won't engage you unless you go down that path. So you can completely skip the forest gargoyle. Yeah, man, excuse me. My words are just getting a little tongue-twisted today. But yeah, we can go straight past him, just to show you. See, we're, you know, heading towards Gargoyle 2. Gargoyle 1, nowhere in sight. So anyway, we'll head this way. There's Gargoyle 2. Now with the lizards gone, we can focus our attention solely on Gargoyle 3. Hey, buddy. Come on. Yeah, things didn't work out for you well that time. Let's see. Two lizards, gargoyle on a roof. Continue on for chunk. So, oh, wait. This way. That's back at the old roof. We're going to continue up here. Is this... Nope, that's where the ladder's at. Okay. Continue on. Now we do have two gargoyles coming up. Chunk. Extended roof. Two gargoyles. Okay. Then we're going to continue this around. And we're going to head down here. Kill this guy. Get ourselves the ember. We got another Hummer right here. Take the undead bone shard from him, and that will get us up to plus 10 on our flasks. Of course, make sure to kick down the ladder. We can re-racks up. I don't really think it's necessary here. We're going to go over here and kill this knight and grab the items that are on that balcony. And that's actually the path from earlier that I said we could jump down, but we are going to wait. I don't think I've ever used that weapon art in combat up until now. I mean, it's actually really cool, because that attack blocks for you, and it gives you a lineup for the smash that comes after the fact. So come out here, get more chunks. And now for a little one-on-three action. One shard, balcony, okay. So in this next area, a couple really cool pieces of loot. We're going to gain access to the Faram armor set, a big fan favorite from Dark Souls 2. Additionally, dual-wield katanas and one of the strongest sorcery staffs in the game. So, there's three guys we're going to fight. You can see them over here. We're going to kind of aggro them and then run back. Now, both the dual-wield katanas and the guy in the Faram armor, they will chase you all the way back. The mage will stay outside. And that's what we want. We want to separate them and fight this as a 1v2 or 1v1 if this guy comes in all willy-nilly on his own. Man, that did not work out well for you. Thank you for the Golden Wing Crest Shield. Just to take a quick look at the shields, as you may remember, we have this one's the dark, we have the fire, we have the lightning, and now we have a high magic one as well. So. Where's Katana Bro? Katana Bro did not want to come along. He just straight up abandoned the Faram Knight. That's kind of sad. Well, I'll kill you first. Oh, what the? Those usually don't shoot from behind. Alright, you're dead. All three of them can drink Estus, but pretty easy to take out, as you can see there. Sage's Crystal Staff, Onikiri, and Ubadachi, and a Large Soul of the Crestfallen. So just to show these, I'm sure a lot of people have been curious about these. I actually just started using them on my Dex playthrough. Very good. That's the R1 move set, and the R2, or excuse me, the L1 move set, and the L2. Boosh. Which doesn't look... it looks super cool. And surprisingly, it actually does a relatively high amount of damage. And then on top of that, it has really good stagger potential. So Sage's Crystal Staff increases the potency of sorceries at the cost of increased FP. Really powerful staff, in my opinion. Obviously, there's some issues with magic and scaling at the moment that are kind of tricky, but... Anyway, so with the three guys dead... Let's see. Right. So we're going to go up here. This elevator will take us back to the original bonfire. No, I didn't roll in time. That's fine. We'll rest. We got 100,000 souls. We can rest up real fast. But we're not completely done this area yet. Still a little bit more to do. So we'll hit the bonfire, get our Estus, and then we're going to take on some angels. So far we're looking pretty good on time. I might include the boss for this area in this episode. It really depends on whether or not I die on the way to the boss. So if we can take down the angels flawlessly, well, not flawlessly, but without dying, then you know, we'll be good. But if not, then might save the boss for the next episode. So anyway, now they're up top. That way is to the boss, but there's some stuff we want to get over here first. We're going to run up here and around this. Grab ourselves, I believe it's a soul, crestfallen soul. Yes. Okay. Now, once we go up here, three fatty guys, you can see them up top. They're very similar to the ones we've been fighting before, except these ones have angel wings. Initially, we're going to ignore them, and we're just going to run. So, run. Get inside. And drop down onto the rafter. Drop down onto the cage. Drop down inside. And divine pillars of light. So that's the miracle that you've seen those guys continually do. They just cause big pillars to shoot it down from the sky. We'll go over here, pick up our blessed gem. No. Go down the ladder. And we have a divine blessing and three twinkling titanites here. So at this point, you could either bone, or if you go out here, this will lead us back out to the initial roof entrance. So instead, though, we have that ladder you guys may remember. So we're going to run over. Trying to get good jukes on. All right, I can do it. Yeah. Got waxed a little bit, but we're okay. Ugh, God, the wax. So sticky. All right, there we go. Now we're able to move again. Had to wait for the wax to start to wear off. And now we're going to go take on those three angels. So these guys are, they're not much different from the just the big blues that we fought, you know, except now they just have angel wings and golden armor instead. They do have one new attack where they kind of jump up in the air and then dive towards you. It's not that hard to dodge. It's actually, God, I always do that freaking turn. It's kind of reminiscent of like a generic boss dive attack, so pretty easy if you keep your eye out for it. I would suggest pulling them one at a time just to make your life a lot easier. Have any throwing knives? Yes, I do. Well, this one noticed me. Good. Come on. Come on. Ow. You can also see clipping does not matter to them. Man, that went swell right there, didn't it? Straight flew through an archway into a flying spin to win. That was pretty fantastic. I wish my character could do things like that. Usually they aren't filled with that much BS, though. We're just going to chalk that up to a fluke. Typically, they don't phase through structures with spin to wins. Like considering the rooftop section as well. I think we'll take out the angels and then probably wrap the episode up there. I don't know, maybe. I'm still torn, because that boss fight will take us probably about 5 minutes, so we'll see. Depends how fast I get these assholes down. Yeah, I would suggest fighting them right here on this roof. The more open area you have, the better. So, we have to run here, and they should dive down. There we go. Ow. Stop with the axe throw. One down. It's going to see 13,000 souls a pop off these guys. On top of that, we get a slab for killing all three. Calm down there, Angel Boy. You gotta love how there's enemies in Dark Souls that can hit just as hard as a boss. Like, these guys are easily on par with fighting a boss. This one's not paying attention. Oh, if I can get a charged heavy attack. Oh, man. Oh. And there's our slab. Here, we're going to head, where's the walkway at? It is. Head on up. Head on up these stairs. And there is our dex ring. Hunter's ring, +5 to dexterity. And do keep in mind as well, you know, as you pick up some of these rings, if you respec, like, even though my stats show 50 right now, because I have on the knight's ring, when you are in your stat screen, if you're respecking, in that screen, you will not see any stats that are gained from ring effects. So, for example, if you are using the Karthus, the Milk Ring, the one that boosts dex and obscures rolling, that actually increases your dex by a little bit. So, like, you know, right now our dex is at 10. I think that's 3. Just want to check real fast, because we're wrapped up here anyway. Yeah, 3. So, basically the point I'm trying to make is just be aware of those stat boosts anytime that you go to respec, because between that ring and the Karthus ring, that's 8 decks right there that won't show up while you're respecing. So do keep that in mind while you're aiming to hit the soft caps or even just a weapon requirement for a particular weapon. So either way, guys, we got 150,000 souls in the bank we need to go spend. On to the next episode. We will be moving our way on up to Prince Lothric, so make sure to stay tuned, and we will catch you then with more Dark Souls 3.